it's TT. I am going to paint my prompt number 3 today, which is cauldron with the letter C. I have already sketched up my little cauldron with its tiny little bubbles everywhere and transferred it using some graphite transfer paper. I start by wetting the entire cauldron with clean water. And then I'm going to lay in a light gray. I'm using a granulating gray, which means that some particles in the color settle into the little crevices of your paper, and some of them sit on top. This causes this color to separate, and it has like a pinkish tone and a brownish gray tone. So it's really pretty when you can actually see it in real life. It's really pretty. And then I'm going to go in here and add a little shadow. There's a little band around this cauldron down here, so I'm just going to add that little shadow band in. I tried to scrub the middle of it out a little bit because I felt like it was too dark in the middle. It wasn't my fave, but I ended up making some changes later anyway. So now I'm adding some more gray to deepen the tones and add more shadows kind of around the rim and the side of the cauldron that is in shadow in the picture. And then I decided I wanted to get a little creative, I guess. I decided I wanted to play today. I took a square, a couple of flat brushes, and tried to add some color. I wanted a colorful, pretty cauldron. So I have seen some other artists take a flat brush and do kind of these just square strokes. And I really liked the look of it, and I wanted to try it myself. Of course, in watercolor, I wasn't quite patient enough, so my first layer of these little kind of square strokes kind of blurred together, so I ended up having to go back over it. I haven't ever tried this technique before, but I thought it was pretty, and I thought it was, you know, different, so I wanted to try it. Now I am grabbing my purple and my blue and going over the edges of all of these bubbles that are bubbling out of the cauldron so that you can see them. I'll add purple, blue, yellow, and pink to try to give those bubbles some color and make them a little bit more interesting. I'm adding the yellow in there right now. And this is Quin Coral, which is what I used for my pink. I thought it was a fun pink color. And it wasn't just a plain pink. It's not like the orangish coral pink. Then I didn't like how white the bubbles were in the middle, so I added a little bit of gray. And then I, since my cauldron had dried, went back in with another layer of those kind of square strokes to add some shadows in the blue and purple that I had chosen. Then I went and got my Neocolor 2s because I never get to play with these and I've just been wanting to. And I decided I wanted to play with those. So I went over the cauldron, some of the highlights with that light blue-gray, and then I went and grabbed my purple and blue Neocolor 2s and just kind of scribbled on there in places that I wanted some more color and some more interest, and I wanted to break up the shadow color that I had put in. Then I added some iridescent sparkly watercolor. It's just like a white glittery mica powder watercolor. But I thought, how magical for a cauldron full of bubbles, the bubbles to be all sparkly would look really magical and pretty. So I thought that was a good idea. Added those in. And then I'm going back over, adding some more highlights to the rim. Now I decided I was going to make my cauldron have some smoke coming out of it. So I wet the paper and then I started adding these kind of purple and blue smoke marks. They look a little flamey to me. I've never painted smoke before other than when I did my campfire painting, and that was a few years ago. So I think I was thinking a little bit more flames than smoke when I painted these, so they're not my, it's not my favorite, the smoke. Going back over it here, I softened the colors and then I went back over it in a white neo color to try to break that smoke up. And then I went over the whole thing and kind of doodled and added highlights with a Uniball Signo white pen. So I kind of went over the bubbles and added a couple of highlights on the cauldron in a few places, and it's in the smoke as well. I'm softening the edges of the smoke a little bit with a white neo color. And I thought I was done, and then I remembered that I wanted to add a shadow. So I was going to show you, and then I was like, oh wait, I was going to add the shadow. Now I'm done. So there it is. It's colorful and fun, and I'm pretty happy with it. Thanks for watching.